Hello everyone, in this session we are going to talk about the structure of environment. Our environment, you can call it ecosystem. Ecosystem is made up of some major spheres. So in this session we are going to talk about the major spheres of our planet Earth. Before we begin with the spheres of environment, we need to understand what is system. So system is a collection of interdependent parts which are enclosed within a defined boundary. So suppose this is your system, it has a defined boundary and there are some interconnected parts which are dependent on each other because they are interconnected. In same way, you can treat your environment as a system. This is called ecosystem. Therefore, Earth is a collection of four interdependent parts and these parts are called spheres. So basically there are four interdependent spheres in planet Earth. So first is lithosphere, second is biosphere, third is hydrosphere and fourth is atmosphere. The names of these spheres have come from Greek word where litho means rock, bio means life, hydro stands for water and atmos stands for vapors and air. In this session, we are going to cover just the overview of each sphere. As I said, our planet Earth is a system and it has some interconnected parts. So lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere are the basic interconnected parts and the portion which is common in these three spheres is known as biosphere. These four major spheres are enclosed within a boundary and this system is called ecosystem. Now, because these four spheres are closely connected to each other, a change in one sphere will definitely result in a change in one or more spheres. These changes are known as events. The events can be natural events like earthquake or hurricane or cyclone, or it can be man-made events like oil spill, air pollution. These events are caused by humans. Once these events have occurred, they will become cause, and each cause will have some effect in one or more spheres, and again these effects will become cause for another events, and then again those causes will have some effect. There is a cycle of cause and effect which is continuously going on within an ecosystem. Apart from this, these spheres are continuously interacting with each other in form of energy transfer and nutrient recycling. And this is done through this common area which is called biosphere. Basically, biosphere is using lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere for energy transfer and nutrient recycling. This is a very simple picture which is depicting all four spheres: atmosphere, biosphere, geosphere is your lithosphere and hydrosphere. Lithosphere, as the name suggests, it is all about land and rocks. Which means if this is the land where you are standing, if you move above the Earth's surface, you will find your atmosphere. And if you move hundreds of kilometers beneath the Earth's surface, you will find your lithosphere. So lithosphere is basically the rigid outermost shell of the planet Earth. When I say rigid, which means cold and solid. Now here, why do I say cold and solid? Because as you move below the lithosphere towards the core of Earth, you will find the Earth becomes hotter. As the Earth is getting hotter, the higher temperature doesn't allow the material to stay in solid state. Therefore, the materials are existing in semi-liquid states, and then near the core, the material exists in liquid state. Now let me tell you, the inner portion of Earth has been divided in some layers, which are crust, mantle and core. So this is the land where you are standing. This land is your crust. Below the crust comes your mantle, where materials are existing in semi-solid state, and then comes your core. Now Earth's lithosphere includes crust, which is the topmost layer, and some portion of mantle. This is the picture which shows you how the Earth looks from inside. So the topmost layer is crust. And crust includes oceans, which means oceanic crust, and continents, which means continental crust. In continental crust, you can see these mountain ranges and huge plains. In oceanic crust, you can also find deep valleys below the ocean floor. So these two are together forming your crust. After crust comes your mantle. Mantle can again be divided into upper mantle and lower mantle. And in that, the uppermost part of upper mantle, which I am coloring with blue color, this is the uppermost portion of upper mantle. So this portion and crust together are forming lithosphere. Below the lithosphere comes your asthenosphere, which is also the part of upper mantle, and then comes your lower mantle. So this is your lower mantle. Then comes the outer core, and then comes the inner core. This is how your earth has been layered beneath the earth surface. Lithosphere is subdivided into tectonic plates. So there are basically 7 large tectonic plates and number of smaller plates. So these plates are carrying your continents, and that's how your continents are moving or floating above the mantle. Let's quickly see why do they float. As you move below the earth's surface, density keeps on increasing, which means the mantle has higher density in comparison to crust. Also, the mantle is in liquid state, whereas crust is in solid state. So below the crust, there is liquid, which has higher density. Therefore, these plates, which have lower density and are solid in nature, are floating over the liquid. Like if you throw a wooden log in river, it will float. Upper part of lithosphere chemically reacts with atmosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere through the soil forming processes. When I say soil forming processes, it means weathering, erosion, or you can say soil liquefaction. So these are some soil forming processes which are forming soil. So if this is the land where you are standing, the upper portion of lithosphere constitutes soil, and this portion where soil forming processes are taking place is called pedosphere. Now lithosphere can be divided into two parts. So this is your lithosphere, which has crust plus upper mantle. Now crust can be divided into two parts. One is oceanic crust and second is continental crust. Oceanic lithosphere is associated with oceanic crust. It exists in the ocean basins. So here you can see this is the oceanic crust, and continental lithosphere is related to continental crust. So this is your continental crust. In continental lithosphere, you can find many mountain ranges, volcanoes and huge plains. You can also find deep valleys and volcanoes below the oceanic crust. Here I have written SIMA for oceanic crust, which means this crust is rich in magnesium silicates. Magnesium silicates. Whereas you can see continental crust is also known as SIAL, where SIAL means aluminium silicates. The second difference is oceanic crust are thinner, but they are denser than continental crust. So here you can see oceanic crust are thinner, whereas continental crust are thicker in comparison to oceanic crust. But if you talk about density, continental crust has lesser density, whereas oceanic crust has higher density. And this is all because of the type of rock that they are made up of. So basically in crust, you can find three types of rocks: igneous, metamorphic, and sedimentary rocks. An interesting thing is, continental crust is good mix of these three types of rock, whereas the oceanic crust is mostly the igneous rock. Here, the oceanic crust is mostly made up of the rocks with a composition of basalt, which is a dark colored rock, and it is heavier in comparison to the rocks with which the continental crust are made up of. The continental crust is mostly made up of the rocks with a composition of granite, which is a light colored rock and slightly lighter in nature. This is the main reason why the density of oceanic crust is higher in comparison to continental crust density.